this is Bach's prelude number one. It is a very beautiful prelude. And it has many ornaments. Most ornaments we have in the left hand. We have several short ornaments, mordants, and we have longer ones. To play ornaments correctly, we need to play them from the keys with a position very close to the keys. Mordants are played on the beat, and we play it from the principal note down and back. If we have note G, it will be G, F, G. And it is very important to play all ornaments exactly on the beat, not before the beat. This would be before the beat. To the last note. So we need to play to the first note. Small accent and just with more importance. Same would be in measure 7. There are two parts here. More metric one up to measure 9 and more liberated one. The one which is more metric could be played more in time, more even, almost with metronome, and the second half could be played more freely because it doesn't have left hand which keeps it in tempo. It has only long note and it is written in more improvisational manner. So starting from second half of the ninth measure, we play a bit more rubato, that part. So we are allowed to have some liberties here. First half is more in tempo. Up to measure 10, we have left hand leading here. Melodic line is in the left hand. And so on. It is a very long phrase in the left hand. In the right hand, we have just harmonic motion, just harmonies and figures. Right hand can be learned in chords like this. This will allow us to understand the harmonic development better, and it will be easier to learn the text. Left hand can be learned without ornaments, just by quarter notes. And so on. And same could be done by both hands, like this. Second half of the piece, starting from measure 9, has motivic development, and it is very important to understand how these motifs are developed. So here are the stops with motifs. I'm stopping after each motif. So it is always the same motion down. It is important to understand the motivic development because the long phrase which starts in measure 11 to the end has little motifs, little components. And practicing with the stops allows us to understand these motifs. Each motif starts from second note, second 16th note, and goes up to the first note. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. And then without stopping, it is important to still hear these motifs. This allows us to dynamics and without changing tempo much. So here how it sounds together. And so on. Tempo can be different. It can be much slower, like this. It can be faster. Only clue we have is time signature for quarter notes. It means that we need to play by four, not by eight notes. So it can be slower. One, two, three, four, one. Or can be faster also by four. One, two, three, four, one, two, three, four. For the motifs in the left hand, it is important to keep the rest, and I would phrase it in such a way, small crescendo and small diminuendo to the centered note, like this one, to this note, diminuendo, crescendo, diminuendo, crescendo, diminuendo, crescendo, diminuendo. This is how it sounds all together.